Well, you guys, I finally drank that sweet, nectary orange Kool-Aid with the most unexpected purchase in my entire history. And so far, it has been absolutely amazing and painful. This is the KTM 1190 Adventure. Yes, you heard that right. I bought a KTM. It's orange, it's heavy, and it even has the word adventure written on the tank. To be honest, I never expected to own one of these, not even the day before I bought it. But when one of the greatest human beings I've ever met, aka Goat Cabeza, aka Brent, offered to sell it to me, fully equipped for just a little more than I could get a bone stock used V-Strom, I could not resist, and I'm glad that I didn't. Have to apologize because I wanted to make this into a seriously cracking reveal video. This is, after all, my first KTM, my first heavyweight adventure bike, the most powerful bike I've ever had, and the most expensive. The thing is, I'd spent 2 weeks taming this beast, riding it over 1,000 miles on and off road, and though the cameras were on, they weren't on me, they hardly ever are. I dreamt of making the 1190 look as amazing as Adam Riemann and Chris Birch did, but it's hard when you only have a hundredth of the talent. But I was getting pretty good at getting the rear tire to break loose and lifting the front up a little, riding through the gnar and even a few jumps on this monster, until it broke my back. See, I'd already been on much, much harder stuff on this bike, and I've been through thousands of little mud puddles at the bottoms of whoops like this, but this one, with the 1190's computers and traction control and who knows what else, threw me to the ground like a rag doll. My face makes a surprisingly good break, which scorpioned my boots back far enough to kick myself in the back of the head. So I'm sorry, but I can't give you the amazing motorcycle reveal this bike deserves. You'll have to go watch Chris Birch, and honestly, the Matt TV channel does a way better job anyway. So you get a few mellow road shots, a few first-person shots, but mostly footage from the 360 camera from me. As for my back, my doc said it's an avulsion, where the little nubs on the side of my spine have broken with the connective tissue. He says it heals like a rib, which means there's nothing they can really do. It just takes time and patience, and it's pretty painful. Luckily, I've wrapped up rallies for the summer and can take it easy and recover until they start back up again next September. So, what do I name this enormous new KTM? Well, it's ridiculously powerful, immensely heavy, unnecessarily complicated, unnervingly smart, and it broke my back. I think I'll call it Bane. I'll be back on it soon because it is unbelievably fun to ride, even on the road. So let's shift gears a bit and talk about the title of this video. Even though I did technically break my back on my new KTM, it's a pretty clickbait title, and unfortunately, YouTube is changing its algorithm once again, and this time devaluing subscribers and going back to favoring click-through rates. That means the clickbait titles and titillating thumbnails will once again rule YouTube. Now here's the thing, this is going to wreak havoc on my channel. Why? Because dual sports aren't popular, and I'm not really into chasing the most popular, newest, coolest trending topics out there. And dual sports, they're definitely not trending. I've never had a viral video, and I never plan to. I don't go after stuff like that. But I do plan to continue to make videos that I like to make of unpopular old motorcycles that YouTube's new algorithm will give literally no attention to. And another change, YouTube will no longer notify subscribers of new content unless they've clicked the bell to be notified. So, if you'd like to continue seeing my videos, please click the bell icon because my videos probably won't show up in search anytime soon. So thank you for hitting the bell icon, or if not. And an enormous thanks to Brent for selling me his amazing machine for so little, and for the producers who make this video and the purchase of this bike possible. And thank you for watching. Much love as always, eveRide out.